बिलाल जमील। बिलाल, कैन यू कमेंट ऑन दैट? डू यू नो व्हाट इज अ बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट?
सर, अ बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट इज यू नो बिल्डिंग अ रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द कस्टमर्स. द एनवायरनमेंट ऑफ अ बिजनेस टू बिल्ड अ रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द कस्टमर्स.
ओके, ऑल राइट, आई विल कमेंट ऑन इट लेटर। राफे, कैन यू कमेंट ऑन इट? और यू हैव नो आइडिया? राफे मुश्ताक,
No, sir, no idea.
ओके, नो प्रॉब्लम, नो प्रॉब्लम। यस, फैजान,
No idea, sir.
नो आइडिया। ओके, हिरा जावेद, प्लीज एक्सप्लेन व्हाट इज अ बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट।
Sir, I guess all the internal and external factors that might affect the business.
Okay, all right. This is somewhat relevant to it. Yes, that's right. But business environment, do remember, the environment can be internal or external. But when we talk about a business environment, it means the region or the market where business operates in. So it means environment includes all those factors which are beyond the control of the business. Do remember, I repeat, business environment is external to the business, right? It is outside the business. So the area where business operates in, right? And all those factors which are beyond the control of the business, they are part of that business environment. For example, government. Can business control the government? Can business control the government? Obviously not. So similarly, can you control customers? I mean, if customers are coming in or the number of customers are increasing, it's not easy. Or reducing, for example. Similarly, if I talk about competition, again, it's beyond the control of the business. If more firms are coming in, you cannot stop them from coming in. Similarly, use of new technology. So if now new technology is there, so can you stop that technology to be used in that industry? Obviously not. So if you won't use that technology, you will fall behind than your competitors, right? So it means when businesses are not able to adapt themselves according to the changing situations which are there in the business environment. Let me explain you. Do you know that at one point of time, Nokia was a market leader and it was very famous? Okay, but what happened when other companies, they turned to smartphones, that is Android sets? Nokia didn't do it. Nokia was late to do it. Why? Because they switched to Windows Phone first. Okay, and that was a wrong step taken by Nokia. And then now you see that Nokia is nowhere near to Apple or Samsung or Huawei or any other famous cell phone which is available because of that action which was not taken at the right time. So their failure to adapt to that change which happened in the business environment. And then what happened actually, Nokia was taken over by Microsoft. Now it is Microsoft Nokia. So that was one of the major issue with Nokia was already established. Think about it, right? Despite of that, Nokia was down and out at a certain point of time, right? Before it was taken over by Microsoft. So what about when it comes to new businesses? So obviously it will have a huge impact and businesses will not be able to survive at all. So, for example, another example I can give you, for example, there is a textile industry where garments are manufactured. So now there is a new technology which helps businesses to manufacture garments quickly, and garments, they are of better quality and less cost is involved because fewer workers will be required. So now if you do not adapt that, obviously what will happen? You can do it because it's your own decision, but it will have a negative impact. Your productivity will not be high, you won't be able to meet the demands of the customers timely, and your products may not have the standard quality which your competitors are having. Why? Because they are using that technology. And you know that technology is less likely to make mistake. Their precision is very high as compared to humans. So that is why they have standardized goods. Now, when I use the word standardized, it means that quality of all the items is exactly the same. So do not get confused by the term standardized. It does not mean a very high quality. Standardized means that if the quality is good, so the quality is the same for every good. So it actually creates a very good brand image, and people like to buy from the business which every time, whenever they buy, they get the same quality. So obviously the business which won't adapt that technology will lose and suffer in the end, resulting in failure. All right, so any confusion regarding any of the factor which may lead to a business failure, you can ask me questions. Anyone? No question? All right, so it means we can move on. Okay, so let me tell you again that today is the last class before Eid, and we'll meet together again next Wednesday. You know that, because we have classes on Friday and Saturday that will be off because of Eid. So I'll see you on Wednesday, right? Okay, now let's move on to the next topic. Okay, now let me show you the external factor. See, competition, legal. Now, legal, obviously, it is related to government. Then economic changes. Now, what are those economic changes? It could be income level of the people, right? Age of the people. Again, you know that for in UK, for example, there is aging population. The average age there in UK is 85 years. So it means now a big chunk of population is old, right? So elderly people are there, which constitutes a major proportion of the total population. So now you cannot simply ignore those people. You have to produce products for them as well. Otherwise, somebody else will target those groups of people, okay, and they may get higher revenue from out of it, right? So you have to go for that segment or market segment as well. Like, you can, for example, if you are in the business of manufacturing shoes, so you need to focus more on comfort, because people who are old, they can compromise on design or maybe the looks of the product, but they cannot compromise on comfort. Because now they are at that age that comfort is their top priority. You know that. Think about it in similar way. For example, you know that in wedding ceremonies, all teenagers or younger people, they do not care about whether it is the month of December or not. They wear those clothes in which they look good. Okay? And even if those clothes do not protect them from intense cold, which is there in the month of December, still they like to wear that because they want to look good. But if I talk about old people, they do not do it. They protect their bodies by wearing sweaters, shawls, or other warm clothes. And you know that warm clothes, they are not that much fancy. But because their top priority is their comfort, so that is why they have a different choice from younger population. So this is one of the economic change which is happening. So now businesses need to address to it. If they won't address to it, they will lose customers gradually. Why? Because people are getting older, and majority of the people are old. So it means you are ignoring such a huge population, a proportion of the population. So you can't do it. So this is a business environment. Same is the case with income level as well. If people's income is going down, now you have to reduce the price of your products. And for that, what you can do, you can reduce the quality of the product as well. Because you know that right now, whatever changes which are happening in the environment, people can compromise on quality, but they cannot compromise on price. Why? Because they have low incomes. And with the amount of income they have, they cannot buy the same item of the same price. So the businesses have to reduce their price to survive there in the market. So this is how businesses, they adapt to those changes which are there in the environment. And those businesses which do not do it, they end up closing down their business. Okay, now, so let's move on. Our next topic is impact of enterprise on a country's economy. So now, when I hear the word enterprise is there, so it means businesses, right? So it means impact of businesses on a country's economy. It's quite easy. Let's discuss them one by one. One is employment creation. It's quite easy. When there will be more businesses in the country or in a region, so more people will be demanded as workers who can work over there at that workplace. So it will increase the employment level in the country. So now, how it is going to give a benefit to the economy? Let me show it to you and then I'll ask you to explain the other points. Let me, now, I'm writing it here. I hope you can see it. Now, for example, I told you that one of the impact of business is employment, right? Now, our topic is how businesses will have an impact on the economy. So now what will happen when there will be employment there? So what will happen? Obviously, people will have higher incomes, right? Why higher income? Because now more workers are being demanded, and for that, higher wages are being offered by businesses. Do remember that. When employment is increasing, it means there are more businesses and every business wants workers to work there at their workplace. So obviously they offer them higher wages. So it leads to higher incomes. And when higher income is there, so what will happen? Government will be able to collect taxes from them. Earlier, for example, they were unemployed. So government was actually paying them a certain amount of money. In all welfare states, like if I talk about UK, Canada, government pays to all unemployed people who are not able to find jobs. Although they are willing and able to work, but they are unable to find jobs. Government pays them a certain allowance, we call it unemployment allowance or job seekers allowance. Okay, so now if they are employed, so there will be two effects. One, now government can collect taxes from them as well, because taxes are imposed on incomes of the people, right? So when taxes will be imposed, what will happen? Again, higher taxes may lead to, let me write it here, higher government revenue, right? Higher government revenue. Okay, and then higher government revenue will be used for what purpose? It could be used for public welfare, right? For example, let me give you an example. For example, construction of roads, building of dams, right? Education or health facilities, right? So it means it will help the economy to grow. Why? Because now more employment opportunities will be created when government will spend, because government also needs workers. And then when more people will be educated, they will be more productive. They will help the economy to grow because more output will be produced. Similarly, if people are more healthy, so again, they are more likely to get jobs and they are more likely to do jobs, because now they do not need to take days off every now and then because they are ill. Now they are not, because their healthcare facility is there. Right, so this is how. Now, you can see that how I linked one point with the other. This is what we call extending your point to the end, right? And this is the way you can go, you can have effective analysis. And remember that if you make connections, it will help you to earn more marks for analysis. Okay, any question regarding this first point? Is that this,
Yes, please. Can you repeat this last public welfare?
Public welfare, okay. Now, when people will be hired, they will be earning salaries or wages. So it means when they'll earn salaries and wages, government will collect taxes from them as well. So tax is a revenue for the government. Why government collects taxes? Because government has to spend it on the welfare of the people. And what is a welfare? Any activity which can benefit common people. So it can be better infrastructure, right? For example, construction of roads, building of dams, or providing education free of cost to the people. You know that in welfare states, education is free. Similarly, healthcare facilities are free of cost to common people. So this is how the economy can be improved, because economy can only grow when the people of their country, they are well off, they are healthy, and they are well educated. Otherwise, because economy can only grow when they are able to produce or provide more goods and services, right? So if people are not healthy, people are not educated, people living standard is low, they are down and out, so obviously they cannot contribute to their potential. Eventually, the economy will not be able to grow at all. Yes, I think I have made you clear.
So what about employment with lower incomes? Then taxes will be lower and...
Yes, so I am telling you that we are actually studying that how enterprise would have an impact on economy. So what is the effect of businesses? They provide employment, na? So why you are saying lower employment? It's about higher employment. Let me write it there if you are confused. It's about higher employment. Right? Businesses provide employment. So is it okay, or still you are not clear about it? Are you unclear?
No, sir. No, sir.
Okay, all right. All right. So this is one point is done, and this is how you are able to develop your points if you really want to get higher marks as far as analysis is concerned. Okay, let's talk about, now I'll ask you rather. Now let's talk about the second point which is there on your screen, that is economic growth. So it is somewhat related with that. But I still want somebody to answer that. Let me pick somebody who can answer that. Farhan, can you answer how enterprise may lead to economic growth? Can you explain economic growth? What is it, Farhan? Farhan, are you there? Yes, Farhan. Farhan, I am asking you. You might have a problem, or I don't know. Okay. Lareb, it's easy.
Sir, as more the enterprises would produce goods and services which might be exported, and economic growth is directly linked to GDP. So as the GDP would also rise, there would be economic growth.
Okay. All right. Thank you very much, Lareb. Okay, let me explain that as well. Now, remember, when we say economic growth, for non-business students, I am explaining that. Economic growth basically means, what does it mean actually? It means, let me write it there. Increase in total output of the country produced in a year. This is what we call economic growth. right, increase in total output of the country produced in a year. Now, for example, if country was able to produce, for example, 10,000 units, right, in year one. Okay, so in year two, the same country was able to produce, for example, 11,000. So we'll call it that there is economic growth going on in the country, because economy is able to produce more than what they were able to produce in the previous year. So this is economic growth. But if I say that, for example, so this is economy, I think I don't want to make it complicated. It's okay. Huh? It's quite simple. Now, economic growth happens because of businesses as well, because I told you that the main job of businesses is to produce goods and services. So when we talk about output, output includes both goods and services. Do remember that. So when businesses are there in the economy, so they will contribute more in the production of, or towards the production of goods and services, right? So there will be an increase in the production of goods and services, and there will be economic growth. Economic growth is always very helpful for the economy and for the people as well. How? Because when economic growth is there, it means more output is being produced, as I explained you, right? So it means one thing, ample goods and services for local people. Now, people can buy those goods easily. There will be no shortage in the market, right? Ample goods and services for the local people, right? Okay, so it means they will find it easier to buy from the market as it is available there all the time. So it will help the people to raise their living standard. So higher living standard will be there as far as local people are concerned, right? Okay, so obviously when higher living standard is there, this is one of the features of economic growth, which is happening in any of the country, right? Okay, so you can link your answer this way as well. The economic growth may lead to higher living standard as well. And Larev said that now the excess amount can be, let me write it there as well, excess amount can be exported as well, right? So exports can happen. Exports may increase, right? Now, when exports increase, it means now money will come from other countries to your country, right? So again, it will be an advantage for an economy. Economy requires foreign currency. I think I told you earlier as well, but I can explain that when exports will increase, let me write it there as well, because there are various ways to explain that. You may not need to explain that, but I am telling you that you can explain one point in different ways. Now, when exports will increase, you will get foreign currency. Do remember that, foreign currency. Okay, and you know that foreign currency is extremely important for every single country in the world. And why it is required? Because no country can claim that they can produce every good or service which is required by the local people. Why they cannot claim that? Because the climate does not support the production of certain goods, or certain countries may not have certain resources. For example, deep sea fish in Botswana is not available. Mangoes in Canada, they are not there because the climate does not support the production of mangoes, right? So for that, you have to buy from other countries in the form of imports. So foreign currency can be used later for imports, because you cannot produce everything which is needed by your people. So you have to import from other countries as well. and to import, you require foreign currency, which will be available to you if you have higher exports. And higher exports are only possible if there are excess amount of goods and services available. Means that when your local people consume the product, still there are some excess stock available. And those extra amount of goods and services can be exported, right? Okay, so it means how? So economic growth helps the country to meet the needs of the local people as well, and it helps the economy to export to other countries as well. So this is how this point can be developed. Okay, any question regarding this point? If you are not clear about it. So I have explained it in two different ways. It's up to you how you explain it. All right. So getting back to the original slide. Next point is decline can be balanced out by growth. Now let me explain that to you. For example, if there is a decline in a certain industry, it can be balanced out by the growth of another industry. For example, these days, do you know that earlier video cassettes were available? Do you know that video cassettes, basically they were actually those things which you can use in a device called VCR to watch videos way back. Now these days they are not available. Why they are not available? Because now they are not in demand. Now there are CDs, DVDs, USBs. We can watch movies online as well. So it means now those industries or firms which were producing video cassettes earlier to be used in VCR, now they were bound to close down their business. But at the same time, now there are other industries or other businesses which are coming in, which can manufacture more DVDs, CDs, USBs, right? So if businesses keep coming in the country, or every now and then there is a new business startup, it will help the economy as well to balance out the loss of one industry which was closed down, and because of that there was unemployment, but it can be covered through another industry which is now growing right in the same country. So this is how businesses help the economy to balance out their growth. Okay, next point is innovation and new technology. So businesses, they are always in search of better products. Why? Because whenever there is a competition, there is a race between businesses to attract customers. And they, in fact, they want to retain their own customers, and they want to snatch the customers of other businesses as well. And for that, they are involved in research and development. So that is why every now and then we see new technology coming in. Either we talk about cars, cell phones, or TV, or any other item which you can think of. So we see different innovation happening all around us, and new technology coming in, even in manufacturing industry as well. So it means it helps the economy. In what sense? That now the economy is able to produce more. Because with those innovations and with the introduction of new technology, now businesses are far more better in producing goods and services in terms of quantity. So I'm not only talking about quality, it will increase the quantity of items being produced by those businesses. So again, it will enhance the potential of the whole country. So again, it can lead to more exports as well, or economic growth. You can link it with them as well. But another way to develop is with those innovations and new technology, people get better off. Why? Because now they can use latest cell phones, latest cars, latest TVs, right? So in that way, living standard of the people increases. And that is just because businesses, they want to compete with other businesses in a better way. So finally, consumers get the benefit of it. Technology gets low in terms of price as well with the passage of time, and people, they are able to buy it more conveniently, helping them to lift their living standard. Okay, then we have exports. So I think we have talked about it. So you can relate it with that, that there are certain businesses, even in Pakistan, which export to other countries. For example, mangoes are exported to other countries. Similarly, sports items are exported to other countries as well. And it actually brings foreign currency into the country. And I told you why foreign currency is important, because later on, you have to buy something from other countries as well in the form of imports. Okay, then we have motivation for others. Yes, because if businesses are flourishing, new businesses coming in, so other people who might not be thinking to start their own business, now they may start thinking of it as well. Think about TV channels. Now there are so many news channels there. Why? Because they see that every new channel which comes in, it becomes successful. So it means that ideal environment is there for such businesses. So they keep coming in, right? So it motivation brings more businesses to start there in the same region or in the country. Then reduce social ills. Now, social ills, what does it mean? It means when people are unemployed, they are involved in some bad things. What are those bad things? Like they might be indulged in robbery, theft, dacoity, corruption. Why? Because they are not getting the money they want, and they want to increase their living standard, or they are so poor that they do not have any other means to support their family. So when businesses are there, people will get employment. Those social evils like corruption, robbery, theft, dacoity, obviously they'll be reduced. So again, it will help improve the image of that country as a safe country, right? Think about Ethiopia or Nairobi, Kenya. There are certain places where I'm telling you, police says, do not visit those places because we are not responsible. Because people are so poor, I'm telling you, they can rob you off, and even police cannot do anything because the government fails to support such people there because the government is so poor there. So social evils, they are growing over there and they exist there. And the government cannot take any action to control them because they lack the resources to support such people or to lift their living standard. So businesses do help that. Okay, last but not the least, that is good use of the skills and abilities. So now as a businessman, you might be able to use your own abilities. I can give you an example. You know that Jeff Bezos, who is actually the richest man on earth, right? So almost his $118 billion is the net worth of Jeff Bezos, who is the owner of Amazon, right? And he is an electrical engineer and a computer science graduate. So he thought of running his own business because he thought that maybe he had the skills and abilities to run a business, especially IT-based, right? So Amazon is a technology business, right? Similarly, if I talk about Mark Zuckerberg or Bill Gates, so again, they had an interest as far as the technology is concerned. Do you know that although Mark Zuckerberg was a dropout from Harvard University, although he attended the college, but he was a dropout. But now imagine that what kind of people get admission in Harvard University. So Mark Zuckerberg was one of them. He was a genius. But because the business was very successful as far as Facebook was concerned, so he dropped that idea of completing his degree from Harvard University. And now you see how successful he is because he was able to use his skills and abilities to good effect. Same is the case with Bill Gates as well. Although Bill Gates didn't have the same qualification as Mark Zuckerberg, but Bill Gates attended the school, but he was a dropout from Harvard College. Again, imagine that Bill Gates was also enrolled in Harvard University because Harvard College is one part of the business school which is there in Harvard University because there are many schools which are under the umbrella of Harvard University. So again, he thought that maybe although he was a student over there, so it means generally there's a misconception that maybe they were not good students, Mark Zuckerberg or all successful businessmen. That is absolutely wrong. They were genius. That is why they were able to get admission in Harvard University. But then they realized that maybe they might be able to, because the business was so big at the time, so they realized that maybe it is better to drop that idea of completing their degree and better to focus on their own business. And now see how successful they are. Bill Gates is number two in the list. Okay, all right. So that's it. That's all for today. If you have any question, you can ask me. Otherwise, you can leave. Thank you very much. I'll see you in the next class after Eid.
Rafael.